Hello and welcome to another video. My name is Boxiest, and today we are going to continue the What If series. What if events had gone differently? And in this What If, we're going to change the history of Cobra Kai. What if Cobra Kai won the house fight at the end of Season 3? So in this timeline, we're actually going to have Cobra Kai show up earlier to the LaRusso house before Eagle Fang shows up, and they're going to start attacking Miyagi-Do. And Cobra Kai is going to outnumber Miyagi-Do, and the Cobra Kais would gang up on the Miyagi-Dos, and Tori would start fighting Sam with help from the other Cobra Kais, and Kyler would start beating up Dimitri, and Chris, with the help of other Cobra Kais, and some of the Cobra Kais would go to Daniel's dojo and grab weapons and start using them against the Miyagi-Dos. This is when the rest of Eagle Fang would show up, and they would see the fight between Miyagi-Do and Cobra Kai, and some of the students in Eagle Fang would try to leave, but they would be cornered by Cobra Kai. And by this point in the fight, most of Miyagi-Do would be down, and it would be Eagle Fang and Cobra Kai. And Miguel would see Kyler, and Miguel would remember all the things Kyler did to him. So Cobra Kai would start fighting Eagle Fang, and Cobra Kai would have the advantage. And in this timeline, Kyler would easily defeat Miguel with the help of other Cobra Kais, and Kyler would re-injure Miguel's spine, leaving him once again paralyzed on the ground. And Hawk would look around, he would see his former friends from Eagle Fang, and he would realize that he was on the wrong side, much like in the original timeline, and he would decide to join Eagle Fang and Miyagi-Do. He would start attacking his former Cobra Kai teammates. But since Cobra Kai was winning this fight, at the point where Hawk decides to switch sides, and the Cobra Kais would gang up on Hawk, and they would start beating him up, and Cobra Kai would defeat Eagle Fang, just like they did to Miyagi-Do, and Tori would finish the fight by using her brass knuckles, and punching Sam, and knocking her out, and leaving her on the floor, and Cobra Kai would trash the rest of Daniel's house, and they would quickly get out of there. And Daniel would show up a few hours later. He would find both Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang injured at his house, and he would go confront Kreese. And since Johnny never saw Miguel injured because he would still be at Daniel's house, Johnny would declare his love to Carmen. And just after that, he would receive a call from Daniel, and Daniel would explain the situation, and Johnny would go fight Kreese. And in this timeline, Daniel would actually be the one to show up first at the Cobra Kai dojo, and he would see Robbie training with Kreese, and Kreese and Daniel would start fighting. And in this timeline, Robbie would defend Kreese from Daniel, and he would give a modified speech that he gave to Johnny in the original timeline, saying that he blames Daniel for him going to juvie, and that he betrayed him, and that he was his worst enemy. And much like Johnny, Daniel would only use defensive techniques against Robbie, and Robbie would be knocked out, much like in the original timeline. This is when Johnny would show up, and he would see Robbie on the ground, and he would think that Kreese was the one that knocked him out, so he would start fighting Kreese, and Johnny would knock Kreese to the ground, and Johnny would knock him out, and Johnny would see if Robbie was okay, and Daniel would call the police to report Kreese. And both Johnny and Daniel would plead that they were acting out of self-defense. And Daniel would tell the police that Kreese sent his students to break into his house and attack his students, and that they trashed his house. So Kreese would be arrested, and Cobra Kai would shut down, and most of the students would be hospitalized, and Miguel would go to the hospital because he would be once again paralyzed, and Johnny would go see if Miguel was okay. And in this timeline, Miguel wouldn't recover, he would be paralyzed forever, and Johnny, feeling heartbroken, would shut down Eagle Fang. And eventually Terry Silver would hire lawyers, and they would bail Kreese out of prison, and Terry Silver would reopen up Cobra Kai with more funding and more students, and Kreese would once again become an instructor there, and Cobra Kai would grow bigger than ever. And Johnny and Daniel would find out, and they would decide to team up, but only with a fraction of their students, because most of their students would be injured. And that is where I'm going to end this what if. Thank you guys for watching. What do you guys think would have happened if Cobra Kai had won the house fight at the end of season 3? Let me know in the comments below. YouTube lets me know that the majority of you are not subscribed, so if you guys could subscribe, that would be much appreciated. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like this video, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. And I'll see you guys next time.